Ben, Stephen, and Jer, thank you very much. Before we go to the coffee break and the all-important group photo, we have one last item. On the topic of moving from discussion to action, I would like to invite the leaders of two tech companies who have an important message to share about one topic that is perhaps more disruptive for our century than AI, the environment, and the role that technology companies can play there. Robert Pajos is the CEO of Telia Estonia, a big, established, old-school tech company, if you will, and Heidi Martisol is CEO of Cache.me, a new startup offering personalized insurance. Robert, Heidi, I'd like to invite you to the stage, please.
Heard all morning very interesting talks about top-notch technology, but then we go outside and we get hit by a weird blast of storm uncommon to Estonia. So this, we can see the change is happening also outside our room or outside our technology space. So 10 leaders in Estonian tech scene came together with a similar worry, how to do more, because so much more could be done. And this resulted in a quick brainstorm and the first draft of the tech at Green Pledge. In 1 month time of very intense work, we have reached to a signable pledge, which today already 32 companies have committed to signing with us together. This summarizes the 3 points somewhere coming up soon, where we basically round up topics what we can do ourselves to reduce the negative impact and what we can do as a tech companies to increase the positive impact we could have. So as a first main and the biggest contribution every tech company could have is really via our products and services change the current very old and wasteful business models. What we also could do is really educate and bring out simple technologies to engage people and make them push, as in the first panel by Hans Christian Baum was said, that make the CEOs change their business model faster, and this demand has to come from the people. So as a next topic.
Yes, so it's not so strange that Telia subscribed to this pledge really quickly, because we were one of the first companies that went into the sustainability development goals and subscribed to those. So examples, yes, there are many, many, of course. I mean, and this is not new, that we are working with refurbishment, we have recycling of our equipment, we have constructed buildings that are power efficient, etc. But we want to go beyond that. So we were thinking about what can we do beyond that, and digitalization, of course, is something that is very close to heart to my company. So what can we do in digitalization? So we come up with what we call the Digital Cleanup Day. In 1 day, we gathered 70 companies, and we cleaned up the computers in these companies, and they were also doing their efforts to clean up. We gathered together about 1 petabyte of unused data that we were considered as trash. What does it really mean? Does it really pay off to work in the digital world? Let me give you an example that comes from a calculation that a colleague of mine made. We have an international audience here, so think about France. France, what's the population of France? 67 million. If each and every French man and woman were to clean out 50 emails from their computer, this would correspond to an energy saving that would keep the lights on for the Eiffel Tower for 42 years.
So, in order to not just leave it as words, one of the important parts is to actually build something that could go global. And we have come up with the idea to build a measurable, trackable, and shareable green index that every tech company could measure its impact, both the impact that we have as a wasters in a way, but also as what we can do to contribute with our technologies or our solutions to actually grow the overall reduction of impact globally. So
this green pledge is an opportunity for us to collaborate as well. So the last bullet out of these four is, of course, a big one. One of the things that I'll give as an example is the collaboration that 10 CEOs of Nordic companies made together earlier this year. It's a sustainable pledge of the CEOs. It's across technology, it's across different industries. It's Swedbank, it's Nokia, it's Telia, it is Vesta, it is a few more companies like that. And I'll give you a number, 100 billion euro. This is what is the total purchase capacity of these 10 companies together. And they have put as a demand on the suppliers of their companies to also be carbon dioxide neutral and have a CEO plan for the end of this decade. And this is also another way of collaborating, but it goes right into this green pledge, so I'm really happy to be participating in this.
So this is just the beginning. We will have an actionable plan done by the end of the year. So, but why are we telling you that? Is as our Prime Minister said on his speech, that if you want to go far, go together. So we would call all of you to become the ambassadors in your own countries, organizations, join the pledge, and help us to really build a metric or a good framework for the whole government, public sector, scientists, etc., to work together and actually make a real impact out of it.
Thank you, Heidi.
Thank you.
Heidi? So there are a few paper copies of the pledge in the Knowledge Partners area, or you can go to the URL and click a link to join. And we hope you can take all of this, all of you will take this idea back home. So now we're moving to the most important part of the morning, the coffee break. Heads of delegations and speakers, please remain seated. We have group photos to take. For the rest of you, we will continue with the breakout sessions at 11:30 a.m., and lunch will then start at 12:45. So please, time for the photos.